Hello everyone, Kelsey here and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm going to show you how easy it is to create a text bubble animation from your phone and have it track to the motion of your text. Now I was actually inspired to create this effect from watching the Netflix series Sex Education. If you have not seen it yet, I highly recommend it. And they actually use the text messaging effect to help drive the story. So I thought for this tutorial, I would show you exactly how to recreate the same look that they did in this series. So for this demo clip, I'm using a clip from Envato Elements, who sponsored today's video. And remember, you can get 70% off your first month of Elements by using my Envato partner link just down below. And by using my link, it helps support the channel. So thank you in advance. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on in. So in this part, I'm going to show you how to design the text message bubbles from scratch, like how to add all the texture and all of that. If you don't want to learn how to do that, you can actually skip ahead to the track motion and download the template that I designed with these text message bubbles already created. And you can get it for free if you sign up to become a patron, and I've put a link just down below, or you can purchase my text message bubble pack that includes sound effects, by the way, from my store. So if you're here to learn how to do it from scratch, let's go ahead and go into After Effects. So here inside of After Effects, I already have my clip pre-loaded up, and now we need to create a new composition. So just click on this icon here, and I'm going to name this Text Bubble 1, and I'm going to be using the full HD 1920 by 1080 pixels. So this is going to be the comp that we create the text in. So let's start with the type tool. To emulate the sex education look, let's first click to type out the name of the sender. So you can see from the character panel, I'm using Helvetica Bold, size 70, and I'm going to select an orange color and make the text all caps. Then I'm going to select the type tool again to type out the simple text message line. And for this text, I'll make it lowercase and change the color to white. Then we can use the selection tool to move the text elements in alignment, stacked nicely on top of each other and left aligned. Next, we can click on the rectangle tool and select the rounded rectangle tool, and let's click and drag out the rectangle tool to create the shape around the text. And you can see that mine is already blue as I pre-selected this color in the fill just above. So now we have the rectangle layer above the text inside of the composition. So let's move the rectangle layer down below the text layers. Now to make the text pop a bit more, let's go to Effects and Presets and search for Drop Shadow. And I'm going to apply this to the first text layer. Then from Effect Controls, I'm going to lower the drop shadow opacity down to 30%, and I'll increase the softness to 10 to make it more subtle. And then I'm just going to copy this effect here, and then I'm going to select the second text layer, go back to the Effect Controls, and paste it, so that way we have a drop shadow on both text layers. And now let's add some more style to give this text bubble a more unique look. Let's zoom into the composition here to get a closer look at what we're working with. And now we're going to add style to the bubble. Right-click on the shape layer and select Layer Styles, Bevel and Emboss. And then immediately you'll see that some nice lighting and beveling was applied to our bubble. You can play around with a few of these parameters to widen the bubble or change the lighting if you like, but I'm going to leave it as is and just turn on Use Global Light. And this will allow me to adjust the global light angles here to get it just right. And now we can add even more style. Let's right-click on the empty space here in the comp window and create a new adjustment layer. Make sure the adjustment layer is on top of all the layers below, so all of the effects we apply to it will be applied to the layers below. From Effects and Presets, search for Noise and double-click to apply it to the adjustment layer. While we're here, also search for Gaussian Blur and double click to apply it to the adjustment layer. Now, from Effect Controls, we can increase the noise to see how it affects the clips. I think around 8% looks good. You don't have to have noise on this clip. I'm only doing it because in the sex education look, it had this kind of noisy hologram look. And so adding this noise helps get us there to achieve a more textured bubble look. Then we can make the text bubble a little fuzzy to match the look of the show. So from the Gaussian blur controls, let's increase the blurriness to around 4 or 5. We don't want to make the text too fuzzy, just enough. Now you might like this as is, but I want to add one more effect. Let's go back to effects and presets and search for glow. This time, I'm going to apply the glow only to the shape layer, not to the adjustment layer. So with the glow, I want to add this subtle purple blue haze around the bubble. So that way it kind of gets that holographic look that you saw in the show. So first I'm going to change the glow colors to A and B colors. And for A, I'm going to choose a dark purple. And for the B color, I'm going to select a light blue. Actually, I think I'm going to make the purple color a little bit lighter, but we can also change this in a moment when we change a few more parameters to see how it looks. So first, let's play with the threshold. I'm going to change this to around 10. And then for the radius, I'm going to change this to 10. And then for the intensity, I'll set it to around 4. And then for composite, I'm going to change it to be used on top. So right now I think the purple glow outline is a little bit too thick, so I'm going to reduce the radius down slightly to around 8. And then I'm going to change the purple color to be more of a bluish purple, so it's more lavender and it will match the text message bubble a little bit better. So now when I turn off the effect, you can see what it looked like without the glow. And then I'll turn it back on and you can see the after. Now I think that the glow adds a nice touch and makes it more unique. So now that we're done with this bubble, we can actually duplicate this bubble comp from the project panel and then open it up and you can change the color to green, you can update the glow colors, and you can update the text content and change the sizing. And you can do this as many times as you need for however many text message bubbles you're going to be animating. And now, once it's done, you can go on to the animation. To add animation to the bubbles, select all the layers here inside of the comp by holding shift and then right click and select pre-compose. And let's call this bubble animate one. Now that it's one layer, we can open up the transform controls on this pre-composed comp. But first we need to move the anchor point to the left bottom corner of the bubble. So that way it will scale up from the lower left corner, kind of like a message. So, when you're doing this, think about where you want it to animate from. Do you want it to be from the left corner or the right corner? Because you can move the anchor point to either corner that makes sense for the scene that you're working with. In my case, for this scene, it makes sense to move the anchor point to the lower left. So once you move the anchor point coordinates to the right place, next you can use the align panel to get it back in the center. So then you can move the playhead to the moment you want it to reach the end of the animation, and you can press the stopwatch next to position and scale. And then move the playhead back to where you want it to start, and then lower the scale down to 0. Now it will scale up over time. If you want to make it faster, you can just click and move the keyframes closer together. To make it more of a natural look, check the box next to the motion blur column. And now as we move the playhead between the animation, you can see that the keyframes have a more natural blur. So now that we have the motion blur, to make the animation between the keyframes more smooth, you're going to select the end keyframes, right click, and select Easy Ease. Now when we play it back, it's just a lot smoother. So now I'll just quickly repeat the whole animation process again for the message to bubble. So now that both of the animations are done, now we can composite these bubbles into the video scene and we can track it to the moving object that we need to track it to and do some final tweaks. So from the project window, let's drag text bubble 1 and text bubble 2 into the video comp layer. We can use the selection tool to reposition them so we can see both bubbles. Now, before we do some custom animations to align them to the scene, first we need to track the bubble to the phone or the hand. So first, let's go up to Layer, New, Null Object, and let's press Enter to rename the null object to Tracker. This will be what we apply the tracking data to. Now with the footage layer selected, go to the Tracker panel and then select Track Motion. This will pull up a track point in the layer window, and you can click on it and move it to a high contrast area. In this case, I'm moving it between her thumb and index where there's a crease. So try to identify a high contrast point in your footage that makes sense. Then hit edit target and make sure it's set to our tracker null object we just created. Then we're going to analyze forward. And depending on your scene, you may also need to go back and analyze backwards. So once the tracking forward and backing is done, hit apply, and now all of the tracking data is on the tracker null object. And now we need to tell the text bubbles to have the same movement as the tracker. And this is actually easier than you think. So go to the parent column next to each text bubble and change it to the tracker. So after you do that to both text message bubbles, now as you play it back, you'll see that the bubbles are moving exactly with the girl as she's walking. And that's all there is to tracking. If you want to learn how to motion track and put the text message bubble behind the person that's walking with rotoscoping effects, you can watch my most recent video up here and you can see how it's done. So now that we have the scene tracked, what we need to do is add a few more custom animations to better fit the scene. So of course we want that first bubble to pop up, and then as the second bubble pops up, we want the first bubble to push up. So we need to make that animation. And then at the very end, we want them to minimize down into the phone. So it's like whoop, back into the phone. And so to do that, we also need to do another pre-comp and some more animations. So let me show you how to do that. The first step is to stagger the text bubble layers. So we can use the selection tool to move a text bubble 2 over so that way it appears later on in the composition. Then we can position text bubble 2 at the exact same place. But the issue here is that text bubble 1 is covering up bubble 2 when it animates up. And this is where we need to animate bubble 1 up above bubble 2. So let's move the playhead right before text bubble 2 begins to animate. And then with text bubble 1 selected, press key on your keyboard to bring up the position controls. And then let's select the stopwatch to create our first keyframe. Then move the playhead to when bubble 2 is fully up on the frame and use the selection tool to move bubble 1 up to the right above bubble 2. So then you can make a few more slight position adjustments until it looks just right. Then we can add the motion blur to the motion blur column to make it look more natural, and also right click on the keyframe and choose Easy Ease from the keyframe assistant. And now we have a smooth upwards push animation. And finally, we need the closeout animation where the text bubble minimizes. To do that, we're going to select both of the layers holding shift and then right click and select Pre-compose. And let's name this to Convo 1, short for conversation. So now that we have one pre-composed layer, we can animate both text bubbles together at once to be minimized. You'll notice as we play it back, the text bubbles are not tracked to the phone anymore. And that's because when we made a new pre-comp, we also need to change the parent here back to the tracker. So now we're back on track. Next, we can use the selection tool to bring the messages back into place. And we can also press S on this layer to bring the scale controls, and we can scale the messages down a bit if we want to rescale them together. And now we need to adjust the anchor point again. So open up the transform tools here on this pre-comped layer, and let's change the anchor point to be where the phone is. So now it's looking good. And then we can scrub to the point where we want it to begin to minimize down into the phone. And we can press the stopwatch next to the scale parameter to create our first keyframe. And then move forward a few frames and then bring the scale down to 0. After I preview it, I want it to better align with the anchor just a little bit better, so I can adjust the point and use the position controls to move it down to a better location. And now it's looking a lot better. And just like before, let's turn on the motion blur and also right click on that keyframe to change it to the Easy Ease. And now it minimizes great. So now it's looking really great, but there's one last thing that we can do to make a big difference to create the same effect from the series. On this Convo layer 1, let's press T for opacity. And I remember this because T is like transparency, which is the same thing as opacity. And then we can lower this down to around 80%. So now the text messages have a more translucent look and you can see part of the scene, behind the bubbles. And this is completely optional, but I think it looks pretty cool. And then I added in a few sound effects from Envato Elements, and here is the final result. So following these steps in this tutorial, you can now add text message bubbles to any moving scene that you want. And I hope that after following these steps, you can start thinking about how you can add technology to creatively interact with your live action shots. So just as a reminder, you can download my After Effects template with these text message bubbles for free by becoming a patron, and you can just use it as a starting point so you don't have to create the text message bubbles from scratch. You can just drag it onto your footage and then begin tracking and customizing straight away. Now, if you prefer Premiere Pro, I also made a motion graphics template, a MoGrit file that you can import into your central graphics panel and then drag it on top of your footage in Premiere Pro and make customizations from the panel, such as updating the text, the color, the size, all of that. But the one downside of using Premiere Pro is that, you know, tracking is manual. You literally have to keyframe frame by frame the position so the text messages will follow the subject. And that's why After Effects is so great. So while I do provide the MoGrit for Premiere Pro, it's better to use the After Effects template because you can just go straight in to tracking. And if you're looking for other types, different varieties of different types of text message templates, Envato Elements has a ton. So for example, you know, like voice messages or sharing a map, there's a whole bunch of great toolkits on Elements that you can download and save to your drive to use forever. And that's what's so cool about Elements is they have a variety of different styles and packs that you can choose from, download, and use them in any type of video and just store them on your hard drive for future use. It's pretty cool. And what's also great, you can get 70% off your first month if you're new. So you can download as much as you want in that first month, and then you can continue on for a whole year. And the benefit of the annual plans with Elements is that it's cheaper than doing the month-to-month option. So I'm a huge fan of Elements, and I'm a partner of them. So I've had my link down below. If you guys want to try it out, use my link and it helps support the channel. So that's all for today's video. Be sure to give it a big thumbs up if it helped you out. Also subscribe so you're notified. And yeah, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.